Like farmers in the U.S., Israeli farmers are also struggling to overcome the COVID-19 pandemic. Israeli President Reuven Rivlin visited farmers around the Gaza Strip to encourage them. And as CBN Middle East correspondent Julie Stahl tells us, he came away encouraged himself.
President Rivlin began his tour in the sunflower fields of Kibbutz Ein HaShlosha, very close to the Gaza Strip.
The coronavirus has opened our eyes to things that were once taken for granted, and we simply forgot them. For example, the importance of the foundation of this country.
Good morning, everyone. 1618 October is the biblical seventh month Feast of Trumpets for 2020, and today I'm going to give you the proof of that. You've seen that video insert that of the barley and also of the wheat, that it was not ready for the occasion. The first moon, the sighting of the new moon, and that also I'm going to discuss that, the new moon, people going on now to say that the full moon is the new moon. I'm going to do that in the next video, and I'm also going to prove to you that the full moon is not the new moon. So they were not ready for the first moon. The barley was not ripe. The first fruit barley was not ripe at the sighting of the first new moon. That was 24th of March. So they had to put it, place the 13th Adar in there to extend it. But okay, so 1618 October is the biblical seventh month Feast of Trumpets for 2020, and I'm going to prove this to you. But, okay, let's carry on, and here is the first proof that I had. Now, many people do not watch the complete video, and I mentioned this part in the last part of this video. And here is the clip. I did not change anything. I did not edit it. You can actually click on that button there, and you can see the editing dates and everything else. Somebody accused me of editing it or put something else in there. That is not the case. Yeah, Virgo and Leo, the beginning and the end, Feast of Trumpets. In this video, I said we're going to discuss the following. Virgo and Leo, the beginning and the end, the rapture of the bride will occur at Feast of Trumpets at God's day and hour. Amen. And then the illustration of the Stellarium. The Stellarium proves that 17 October 2020 is Feast of Trumpets. And I said that on the 4th of February. I discussed this matter with Mike Ports and also with Len Hamel. And he said, yeah, I saw you that you said that October could be the Feast of Trumpets. But having said that, you the lone wolf saying that October is the Feast of Trumpets, that's not gonna work. So I went with everyone else, although I checked the calendar months and it showed September the 7th month, but Because the barley wasn't ripe, they needed to place a 13th Adar in that to do that. And I think in 2011, two witnesses turned up at the Sanhedrin in Jerusalem, and they declared, believe it or not, that was 2011. They turned up and they said that the barley is not ripe, according to the, the biblical biblical standards. So who was that two witnesses? People were still baffled about that 2011 incident. Having said that, here is the first proof. I already said that in February. But let's go on. I'm going to show you the candle. I'll hold it, the menorah now. And I want you to have a good look at it. The fifth candle is about to be lit on Feast of Trumpets. Passover has been fulfilled. Unleavened bread has been fulfilled. First fruits has been fulfilled. And Shavuot, Pentecost, has been fulfilled. The next one to be lit is the fifth one. And those that say, yeah, it will happen at the Atonement, you're completely wrong. Even Tabernacles will only be fulfilled when we come into the millennial reign with Christ. We cannot have a rapture there. God is a God of order, and He always works in sevens. And you can see there, it's stipulated on time, He fulfilled the first four in order. Not out of order, in order. And the next one will also be in order. So, Jesus is coming 2020 on Feast of Trumpets. As I'm saying that to you. And I've been praying over the seeking God's face concerning this matter before I made this, doing this video. So this is the scenario. Jesus must come on Feast of Trumpets to fulfill the fifth candle holder. And I'll clear that I did the video on this, and this was the insert of a previous video from which Jesus, Yeshua, was talking to Sarah. That was in a vision, of course. And He showed her that the next one, candle holder to be lit, is the fifth one on the menorah. So I believe that word is true. Having said that, I want to just go briefly over the candle, the candle holder. I'm going to do another video on the menorah, and probably not in the next video, and I'm going to share that with you as well. Now, I was in the spirit of the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a great voice as of a trumpet saying, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last. And what thou seest, write in the book and send it unto the seven churches which are in Asia, or unto Ephesus, unto Smyrna, unto Pergamos, unto Thyatira, and unto Sardis, and unto Philadelphia, and unto Laodicea. And I turned to see the voice that spoke with me, and being turned, I saw seven golden candlesticks, and in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like the Son of Man. Yeshua was standing in the middle of the candlestick. He is the menorah. It's a personification of the menorah itself. Yeah. Okay, yeah, now seven prophetic pictures of Jesus, the Christ's first and second comings, are reflected in the seven branch menorah. In fact, the seven branch menorah is a personification of Jesus the Christ, Yeshua, the light of the world. As such, each branch of the menorah equal each of the seven feasts. Also the seven churches, for that matter, which means that both the feast and the branches are definite prophetic signs about the redemptive ministry of Jesus Christ. The feast is the church of God must come in line with the God's feast, because the feast of God is his redemptive plan for mankind. It is about harvest, and it is barley, it is wheat, and it is grapes. You can read that in Leviticus 23. If every one of the church members had knowledge and understanding of God's feast, there would have been no squabble about mid, post, and pre-tribulation, because that is about the barley. That is about the harvest. Okay, so let's carry on. Right of the center of the branch are three branches that symbolize the three feasts that deal with Jesus, the Christ's second coming. The first of these three branches is the branch of the Feast of Trumpets. This is the next one that needs to be fulfilled. Cannot be in atonement unless there is a jubilee year. But having said that, 2020 is not a jubilee year. 2027 will be the 120th jubilee when Christ will return. Amen. So 2020 is not a jubilee. That is a lie from the enemy. Yeah, this is all to distract you. Now, both the branches and the feast signify the rapture of the bride of Christ. The next branch is Feast of Atonement, which Jesus will fulfill when on the 120th Jubilee, as I said, and then Feast of Trumpets will be moved to Feast of Atonement. Okay, both the branch and the feast signifies the visible body return of Jesus Christ. The last branch is the Feast of Tabernacles. Both the branch and the feast signify the beginning of the millennial reign, the seventh branch, when God will fulfill his salvation plan for mankind. Yeah, so here the sun and the moon were appointed by Yahweh, God, for signs and for seasons and for days and for years, Genesis 1 verse 4. Let's see if I didn't skip it. No, I didn't skip it. Let's go back there. Let's go start over again. The sun and the moon were appointed by Yahweh God, for signs and seasons, for days and years, Genesis 1:14. Now the word there for seasons is moedim, and literally means an appointment. You accuse me of date setting. I'm not setting Feast of Trumpets. It's God that set Feast of Trumpets on the first day of the seventh month. And that happened to be on the illegitimate one of September, 20 September. That was on 20 September. The legitimate one is 16, 18th of October. And I'll prove that to you. Okay, so here that means appointed. It's a fixed time in the season. It's a fixed date. And to explain to you, I did not count down 40 days. I counted 40 days to Feast of Trumpets, where they normally prepare themselves for the return of Jesus. And that is what I was doing. Thus Yahweh appointed the heavenly bodies to determine the appointed times. Do you hear that? You got an appointment on a set day, 12 o'clock at the doctor's surgery. God also got appointment. And there's no such a thing as no man knows day, the day and hour. It's appointment that God set, and Feast of Trumpets is that season. There's no doubt about it, you know? Okay. So, obviously, weekly Sabbaths, annually holidays and festivals from the moment of creation. All authorities agree that the basis in the law for Yahweh's calendar is indeed found in Genesis 1. And God said, let there be light in the firmament and the heaven to divide the day from the night. And let there be for signs and seasons and for days and years. And God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night. He also made the stars, Genesis 1, 14, 16. Now, in the ancient days of Israel, they did not have an almanac or a calendar for that matter, and the signs in heavens was their calendar. They just looked, if they want to know what is the first or second day of the, they just looked for the moon, and they will see that it's either the 20th or the, that was the calendar. And that, and they went to want to know when is the season for the harvest. They will look either up at Pleiades or Aries for that matter. That is another sign where they looked up and they see Pleiades or Aries. Then they know this is a sign. And each listen, tell me now. I'll tell you, each zodiac for the month indicated a month for them. In which month are they? Are they in the first month, second month, third month? God used to operate in that way. The first month, the seventh month, and each zodiac indicated to them which month they were. That was the calendar. So you cannot fool the ancient people. Yeah. So these four words in Genesis, signs, seasons, days, and years, can be defined in the following way. Signs fairly define the underlying Hebrew word implying astronomical events such as eclipses and other we observe with our eyes in the sun, moon, and stars, reminding us of the oath that God has made for us. Yeah. Now the sun generally marks days, and after the 12 moon cycles have passed, the earth would have gone through nearly four seasons of weather changes, constituting a year marked with the sun for four distinct earth tilts, causing equinoxes and solstices. These are determined by the angle of the sun throughout which the sunlight hours grow longer to a threshold at which they then begin growing shorter again. Now, finally, the word seasons appear in the first glance to be the four radical weather shifts each year, winter, summer, spring, and fall or autumn. Israel called it a fall week. Normally in our country we call it autumn. However, although the English word certainly implies such an underlying Hebrew word, mo-wada, that is in Strong's 4150, literally it means an appointment that is fixed. You hear that? Not Vincent Vinan's date. It is God's date. It is fixed. By implication, as assembly, as convened for a definite purpose. Technically, the congregation, by extension, the place of meeting. Do you get it? Unfortunately, in the 4th century, rabbis of Babylon polluted Yahweh's sacred calendar by introducing the continuous week and postponements to prevent certain days from clashing with the Saturday Sabbath. Yeah, that Saturday Sabbath is not the God's Sabbath day, which they had created. When Hillel the Second introduced these changes, not all of the religious leaders of the Jews went along with it. In fact, a large number of the leaders continued to observe the new moon moons by observation, as was done in Yeshua's day. Finally, the word season appears at first glance to be the four radical weather shifts each year, as I already explained to you. That's it. Passed. Now, the date, let me just go back a frame there. There are several requirements to determine Passover and Feast of Trumpets. And that, of course, is the green ears, or called Abib. And now I'm going to show you, stay with me right till the end. Do not switch all the way. Otherwise, you're going to miss some very important detail. Okay, now the green ears and whip that is the first, that's the ink, this insert of that clip that I showed you the first time. Now, Manchild Ministries made me aware of that, that Tangish. I got that links from him, and I'm thanking him for that. In order to calculate the correct months of Yahuwah's calendar and therefore the correct holidays, the following information is necessary. Now, the date and time of Tishri is the autumnal equinox in Jerusalem. That must be it, what is it? And of course, the 20th happened before the autumnal equinox, which was on the 23rd. Of September. That cannot be the case. And I will show you another another one that, okay, I'm coming to that. Let me put it to that like that. Let's put it go. Now, here's another one. The date and time of the first visible crescent of the new moon in Jerusalem, that is indicator, the local time of Jerusalem sunset is important. Verify that the Pleiades, as I said earlier, Pleiades and Aries is a very important sign for planting and the harvest and harvest the harvest as such. That should be verified. You know, to the first new moon after the vernal equinox. If not, a 13th month must be added or inserted into the calendar. Venus, this is a very important sign. Venus must be in conjunction with Regulus in Leo first, before first Feast of Trumpets. I went through several of them and Venus always appears, especially in the previous one, Venus always appear first. But, however, I have to say that on the 20th of September, Venus did not appear. Venus only appear on 2nd, 3rd of October. So Feast of Trumpets did not happen yet, people. And I'm going to illustrate that for you in the Stellarium in a moment's time. Now, as I said, the ancient Jews had no almanacs or telescope to determine when the lunar conjunction would occur. They had no choice but to use the visible crescents. Revelation 12, 1-5 relates, there appeared a great wonder and a sign in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun. That, of course, happened 23rd September, and the moon under her feet. And I have to say that Venus appeared just 2 days earlier, was in conjunction with Regulus. That's 2 days earlier on 2017. Okay? Yeah. And she brought forth a man child. This is the constellation Virgo, when the sun passes, listen to me, crosses through a body in mid-October. There's always a time, it should always pass her body at the midsection of Virgo. And that is normally in the mid of October. In the early days, in Jesus' days, the close proximity was September. But as time moved on, you know, it shifted. The exact time of the Feast of Trumpets in many years. Now, that's another point. What about the green ears, as I mentioned earlier? Should we use green ears or the equinox to determine the new year's day? Yeah. So the sun makes the barley ripen, not the other way around. From the time of Adam to Noah, that was, of course, 1,656 years. Green ears could not have been used since springtime existed continuously. There was only spring in those days when Adam lived. That was until until the 1600s. A water vapor cannot be covered the entire earth in those days. Now, Yeah, okay, let me show you. This is a picture how the first fruit barley should be looked like. And you all saw that was totally green. It you could not have declared the first moon then, what is it? It should have been done, moved forward to April. The first moon when they declared it was this year was 24th of March, so they should have moved it forward to April, and then they counted that as the first month of the moon. So October 1617 is the legitimate one. Following the flood, seed time and harvest, cold heat in summer and winter, Genesis 8 verse 2 began. The earth axis shifted 23.4 degrees from the vertical creating the seasons. Also on board the ark, Noah was not able to examine the barley feast in Israel, Genesis 8:13, or anywhere else for that matter. Therefore, he must have used the equinox to figure, or Aries to figure out the holy days, or Pleiades for that matter. Jehovah God says, I change not, and that is in Malachi 3 verse 6. Following the escape from Egypt, the Israelites were led in the wilderness for 40 years in Deuteronomy 29:5, without having the opportunity to examine the barley in Palestine. Palestine was occupied by the hostile Canaanites. Apart from this, the barley is variable. It ripens fast in warmer latitudes than in colder areas farther from the equator. Also, the barley ripens faster in the valleys than on the mountains. What about the southern hemisphere? The cycle season there is the exact opposite, leaving the equinox as the only surefire way to determine the seasons. Now, should the new moon be determined before or after the equinox? This is Deuteronomy 16 explains that to you. You can read it yourself. Exodus 23:15 and 34:18 all state that the moon must be of the green years, not before that. There had to be enough barley developed for the wave sheaf. Deuteronomy 16 says, observe the month of Abib. What does it mean? That, of course, is when the barley is, you observe it, when the barley is still green. And then you observe it until the first fruit barley is ripe. And that you do. And then you declare the first moon cycle, the first new moon. That's it. And that's not a full moon, by the way. It is the new moon. I'm going to give you another video to prove that to you. Now, should the new moon, did that. Now, Exodus 15, thou shalt keep the feast of unleavened bread. Thou shalt eat unleavened bread 7 days, as I commanded thee in the appointed of the month Abib. What is Abib again? That is for when the green gears, when the barley begins to ripen. That you need to observe that. For in it thou comest out of Egypt, and none shall appear to me empty-handed. And there, when you observe God's feast, there are 7 blessings to God's feast. You can read about the 7 blessings that God gave us if we honor his feast. Okay, this is a time frame when Jesus was born. And if you look at there, the moon is right under the feet, and this is the time when Jesus, that is the moon. That was right down. You cannot argue with the heavenly sign. There's a slither of the moon. That is a slither of the moon. And Jesus was just born right after 18 hours. That is the time when he was born. So here you have that Jupiter and Regulus were in conjunction. Venus already conjunct with Regulus just prior, and that was in the 8th month. Yeah, so here you find Venus, Mercury. Mercury always need to be present in also to declare a feast of trumpets. And the sun is, sun most of the time is in the midsection. And that happened to be in October. So it must come after the equinox. Okay, so here is the moon at the feet. Now if you go back to, let's go to back to 2020. And there you will let go to the 18th. And there you see the sun was very high up. Here was the moon. The moon, of course, the moon only came then on the, the moon was only on the 19th at the theater. That was, of course, midday. If you look, that was at midday. The moon was at Virgo's feet. So here you see, where is Venus? Venus is still high up. Venus should pass Regulus before you announce the Feast of Trumpets. And that, of course, did not happen. Oh, do you see where my point? Let's look at 2017, when what's name appeared. That was a legend. A legal Feast of Trumpets on that day. Let's go to the 23rd. And there you see, there's Venus. Venus just passed Regulus, just 2 days prior. Let me go back. So it was in conjunction with, what's his name, on the 20th. On the 20th with Regulus. There you can see Venus was in conjunction with Venus on the 20th. Can you see my point? Yeah, and I can show you all previous conjunctions that Venus appear first before you can declare a Feast of Trumpets. So that only on the 3rd of October, and that is now the 17th, let's go back to 2020 again. 2020, the 10th month, yeah, and that happened to be on the 17th. And Mercury is still in Virgo. Mercury is still here to declare a Feast of Trumpets. And then you see the Venus is already passed. It should not have taken place. There is the ultimate picture for you. There's Venus, of course, it's after. Now, Venus was lying above Regulus when they declared Feast of Trumpets. Okay, so that is my proofs and my viewpoint. Jesus must come on Feast of Trumpets to be fulfilled. So that is my story. Please share this video and do not be discouraged. Jesus is coming. It must be fulfilled. It cannot go beyond 2021. Then Daniel's timeline will not work. Daniel is accurate it cannot dispute that. That is a message from God given to Gabriel to tell Daniel when Jesus appeared the first time. And that happened to be 27 AD. And you count 2,000 years to it. 40 jubilees is 2,000 years. And Jesus came in the 80th jubilee. And 2,000 years, 27 is 2,027, minus the 7 years deducted from that, from 2,027 is 2,020. It must happen in 2020, people. That's all that I have. Love you all. Do not give up. There's already people going back in their normal syndrome. Keep watching. Jesus is coming. God bless.